See, that's what kind of confuses me because baby is that little, but man, I'm like super bloated right now. Hope there's not two in there.
You set my world on fire. You're my heart's desire.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today, I can't believe I'm actually making this video, but it is my first month pregnancy update from weeks one all the way through weeks four. So I cannot believe I'm making this. I'm actually really excited about this update because I haven't felt any morning sickness yet, but I know that's probably coming, but I'm enjoying it while it lasts. The non-nausea, that is. So I'm enjoying that part while it lasts because I was very nauseous with Aria and I know it's probably just around the corner for me. Okay, how I'm going to structure these videos, these monthly updates, is just my symptoms and my thoughts from beginning to end of that month. This month, I'm gonna start all the way back to my week of ovulation, which I guess technically that is week two in like medical terms, because your first week of pregnancy is technically the last period you got. So it doesn't really make much sense in my mind, but most of this video is going to be dealing with the symptoms that were leading up to my positive pregnancy test that was at 3 weeks. So my very first thing that I have written down was the very first discussion that Hunter and I had about whether or not we thought we'd be pregnant this month. And that was like the week of ovulation, and I just looked at him and I lifted up my shirt and I showed him my belly and I was like, "Do you think we made a baby this week?" And he's like, "I don't know, maybe." I was like, "Well, talk to it then. If you think we made a baby, it's in there. Talk to it." And so he was like, "Hey, little buddy," and he was like touching my belly. So I don't know. I guess like from that moment, I just wished that we were pregnant because I just envisioned that there was already a baby starting to form in my belly from that moment. So I really think that that helped me be in a mental space of positivity for this month. And then the next symptom that I was having was being very emotional about everything, like extremely emotional. Yeah, it was bad. For example, Hunter and I were watching a TV show together and I think I wanted to watch another one or I was finishing a different show, I don't know. And then he like grabs the monitor and the bottle and he's like, "Okay, well I'm gonna go up and take a shower and get ready for bed." And I got so mad, like, "Hunter, this is our chance to spend time together. I don't understand why you just wanna go upstairs and go to bed instead of being with me. Like, don't you just wanna be with me?" And so I was really upset and he was like, "I want to go to bed." So I felt bad because I was irrationally upset with him. And so I went upstairs and he was like, "Are you upset?" And I said, "Well, yeah, because I had to do a lot of stuff before I came up and I just wished you would have helped me." He was like "What?" I said, "I don't know. I just feel like the house is always messed up and everything's always dirty and I can't ever get anything clean enough. And I had to put all the dishes in the dishwasher and I had to clean off all the counters." And then he was like, "There wasn't that much dishes that needed to be cleaned. Are you sure that that's why you're upset?" Because he knows that I just get emotional. And then I was like, "I don't know. I'm just upset about that. And then I'm upset about something else." And then I just started crying and I was like, "I just want a baby." And I'm just like, "I just want to be pregnant and I just want a baby." So it was just a very emotional evening. And that sort of thing happened a couple days leading up to the positive pregnancy test. Very emotional. So my next thing was vivid dreams. But I normally have vivid dreams, so I didn't really think that this was a pregnancy symptom. I mean, I'm very emotional too, so I wasn't really linking that with pregnancy too. But these were like, I remembered them specifically and I don't know, it just felt, something felt different about these dreams. For example, I had a dream that I was in prison, don't remember what I did to get there, and I just wanted out so bad to see my little sister. Don't know why, didn't want to see my husband, didn't want to see my other sisters, didn't want to see my parents, didn't want to see anybody, just wanted to see my little sister. Maybe it's because I was thinking about her wedding the other day, I don't know why, but I just wanted to be out of prison to see my little sister. And then she like broke me out of prison or something, and then I went to go see her, and she had like, you know those gender reveal balloons, like they're huge? So she had a gender reveal balloon, but it was pink, and she just had it waiting for me. She's like, "Hey," like excited to see me after I broke out of prison, you know? And I run up to her and I just start bawling like crazy because I was so excited to see her. And then I woke up, but I still remember it. It was really weird. I don't know why. Maybe it means I'm having another girl. I don't know. It was just a really random prison dream. The next thing that was kind of weird for me was I started to look up baby videos and watch like pregnancy TV shows. If that makes sense. I would go on YouTube and look up like baby girl names, baby boy names, unique names, baby names. I don't know. I just looked up all these videos and Hunter's like, don't do that to yourself if you're not pregnant. You shouldn't do that to yourself. And I looked up those videos and I also found this new show on Netflix and I want them to have more seasons of it. It was actually really good. It was Yummy Mummies and it's Australian. It was about four different pregnant women who have like a ton of money and it was just fun to watch, but I don't know why I was doing that to myself because I don't know, like when you're trying to conceive you try to not look at other pregnant people just because you know that it's harder for yourself. I don't know, but it was really fun to watch and I wanted to watch it so bad that month and I don't know why. And then the last symptom that I had that really started to get me thinking was belly twinges, and they were like down here, like in the sides. I don't know. It felt like I had worked out too hard and I had done a kickboxing exercise the day before. So at first I was like, eh, it's not a pregnancy symptom. It's just I worked out too hard. And then I started thinking, I knew that it hurt me bad enough to stop talking and go, ow. So I knew that that wasn't really like a cramp after an exercise twinge. So I looked it up and I know it's like a no-no to look up symptoms and ask if they're pregnancy symptoms to Google, because look up anything on Google as a pregnancy symptom and it will be a pregnancy symptom. I guarantee you that. But I looked it up on Google. Sure enough, people were saying it was a pregnancy symptom. But it was like surprisingly a good amount of people that were saying it was a pregnancy symptom. Enough for me to actually think, oh dang, I could actually be pregnant this month. And so then I started linking that up to all of my other symptoms, like being emotional, my vivid dreams, and looking up baby names, and all of my symptoms, I started linking them together. And then I'm like, I could be pregnant, like for real, this could be for real. And then I just started to get so excited. And then I think it was the next day that I was testing. It was 2 days after the belly twinges that I think I took my pregnancy test. And then the latest symptom that you guys have probably noticed since I started talking in this video, lovely sinus infection. I haven't had any nausea or anything yet, which has been amazing, but I have this lovely sinus infection that has made me very sneezy, very runny nose, very, very runny nose, and it's just like my sinuses burn, man. Ugh. So I hope that this goes away soon, but yeah, now I think it's starting to travel down because it's starting to turn into a little bit more of a cough now, but definitely have some sinus issues going on in the first part of this pregnancy, but I'm not too worried about it. Definitely not as bad as nausea, so I'm taking it for now. The only other thing is just I am getting tired now. I try to take naps when Aria takes naps. I just get more sleepy during the day. No, I've started to notice that I like to go to bed early like Hunter does now. He loves his sleep, man, and he likes to go to bed at 9 o'clock at night. And right now, that's perfectly fine with me. I'm good to go to bed at 9 o'clock. Normally, I'd like to stay up to like 10 or 10:30, and now, yeah. Okay, Hunter, let's go to bed at 9. I'm good with that. So I think that's everything as far as what I've been feeling right now. And I have this new pregnancy app that I downloaded that you guys definitely need to check out if you're pregnant. Pregnancy Plus. And it tells you how big your baby is, but it also shows you, like, right now I'm technically in week 5 of my pregnancy. So I'll show you what that one looks like. This is what the baby looks like right now. It's funny, you can touch it and it'll respond to you touching it, and you can move it around. You also press this little button down here and it'll show you that is the actual size of my baby right now. How cool is that? That's the actual size of my baby. It's so little. Aww. See, that's what kind of confuses me, because baby is that little, but man, I'm like super bloated right now. Hope there's not two in there, but if it is, we'll make it work. But I just think that is so cool. Aria's starting to wake up, but I want to show you my belly really quick before I end the video. So I want to show you my belly every month and see how it grows. And it's already grown, I feel like, a lot, but I don't know, you guys might not notice, but to me, I feel like I already have a little baby bump. Hunter says it doesn't look much different, but I feel huge. I mean, not huge, but I feel bigger than I normally do, definitely. But yeah, so there's my little baby bump so far. my little 5-week baby bump. Yeah, you can see all my stretch marks from Aria's pregnancy. I'm expecting a lot more stretch marks because oils did nothing. I did oils twice a day, pretty much every day for Aria's pregnancy, and nothing. Still got lots of stretch marks, but you know what? It's all right. I don't really care that much. So it's gonna happen. I know it's gonna happen and I'm prepared for it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments if you want me to do anything specific as far as a video that's pregnancy related. I'd love to hear your suggestions and what you'd like to see from me moving forward. I wanna get to know you guys a little bit. So in the comment section, would you guys do me a favor? Okay, so leave your name, where you're from. I also want to know if you were to be any fruit, what fruit would you be and why? Just a get to know you question. I'd kind of want to be an orange just because you have to peel my shell a little bit to get to the good stuff. That sounds so weird. I don't know. But if you were to be any fruit, what would you be and why? I still think I would be a fruit just because you have to work a little bit to like get to know me and peel a shell. Ogres have layers, so does Maggie Rose, but I like oranges, not onions. Oh my gosh. This video has gone way off topic. I can't even. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope to see you next week for my next one. And don't forget to keep finding the joy in every situation, no matter how hard it might be. I definitely need to focus on that this week, so I'm trying to let you guys know what I'm focusing on so you can try to focus on it too. So focus on the good times. Just keep trying to find the joy. Keep smiling. Thanks, guys. Bye! Lay down. Lay down. Go lay down. Go lay down. Go lay down. Lay down. Bring on the stretch, no, don't bring on the stretch marks, that's awful to say. I put mousse in my hair and put makeup on today for you guys. You're welcome. I just wanna love you, just wanna hold you, just wanna be with you till we grow old. You tell me you'll stay or take me away, I want you for myself every single day. Yeah.